Every second counts in an emergency. According to the Special Operations Medical Association, 80% of mass casualty patients are brought to medical facilities in something other than an ambulance.
Graham 2's Rose Belts was with the Spokane Fire Department today to learn how they get people prepared for those emergencies.
Someone can bleed out within 3 minutes, and it's totally preventable.
But the likelihood of surviving a mass casualty drops significantly if bleeding is not stopped on site. According to the National Trauma Institute, hemorrhaging is responsible for almost 35% of pre-hospital deaths and 40% of deaths in the first 24 hours after a traumatic event. We can change that. Today, local first responders were a part of Stop the Bleed, a national campaign to empower bystanders to act as immediate first responders.
Time is very sensitive with trauma patients. So if you have a patient that's bleeding uncontrollably and they have methods to control that on scene by a bystander, it's minutes, it's life, it's lives saved. As a matter of fact, bystanders applying tourniquets, the mortality has decreased sixfold.
They introduced bleeding control tools and kits already used by first responders and the military. You will be seeing them on the walls of public spaces, airports, shopping malls, in your place of business. In it, you will find tourniquets and what you need to stop a bleeding wound and give time for help to arrive. And if a kit is not available, something simple as a piece of clothing can save a life.
Absolutely. So the shirt off your back. Okay, so you can use your shirt to pack a wound and bleeding and hold pressure on it for bleeding control.
The point? Anyone, anywhere can provide simple medical care to a victim that stops the bleed. Rose Belts, Creme 2 News.